Welcome to Managing Regulatory Records in a Defensible and Immutable Way with Microsoft 365. I'm Roberto Iglesias, and I'm part of the Microsoft 365 Compliance Product Group, helping ship the Microsoft 365 Records Management Solution. I'd like to start today by just talking a little bit about what's been going on with Microsoft 365 Records Management lately. Last year, when we came to Ignite, we talked about how you could use Microsoft 365 Records Management, a new solution we were launching within the Compliance Center, to meet and manage all of your legal, business, and regulatory record keeping obligations. Over the past year, we focused around three key pillars that we've been delivering on. First, the concept of being built in right into the Microsoft 365 Productivity Cloud, right where your end users are at, so that you don't have to teach them any new interface or system to learn additionally to what they're used to. Second, around the intelligent and being able to automate and make sure that compliance is not what your end users have to worry about, but you can actually focus on having them on their core business functions, and compliance just happens by design thanks to automation. And then finally, defensibility. We've been working hard to make sure that everything that you do within records management can be defensible to your organization and regulators as you need. As we've advanced through this year, we've been humbled by the interest and how large organizations across all industries are leaving their on-premises or legacy methods of doing records management and migrating into Microsoft 365 Records Management, which is super encouraging. Now, as we look forward, though, we've heard from some of those very highly regulated industries or customers that they've talked to us about how they can really meet some of those most strict immutability requirements that are many times based out of antiquated or old legacy regulations that are based on write once, read many, non-erasable formats. A lot of these regulations have been created for either paper records or very early digital records that were written on non-erasable hardware. All of that presents a challenge when we think about how do we equate that to the modern cloud world of trying to keep many data centers with copies of your information so that they can be as scalable and as performant as Microsoft 365 is. And so it's for these organizations that are trying to meet these really high stringent requirements, which are common across organizations like the Security and Exchange Commissions or FINRA or CFTC, we're very excited to announce the Regulatory Record Label. We introduced at Ignite the Regulatory Record Label as a new way to be able to define a more strict and robust way of meeting immutability within Microsoft 365. The Regulatory Record Label builds on where the record label started of restricting some of the collaboration, but it adds a lot more restrictions. So for example, once that you've applied a regulatory record label, nobody within your organization, even your global administrator, will be able to remove it. Additionally, the record will not be able to leave the location that it was declared in, and you won't be able to edit the metadata. All of this will help prove the integrity and make sure that 10 years from now or 30 years from now, when you have to prove that this is the actual record that was there initially, you can do so with confidence. Now, I know you want to see this in product, so let's jump right in. To go through the demo, we're going to go through three different steps. We're going to talk about defining, classifying, and executing. In the define, we're going to talk first about how do you create one of these regulatory record labels and what are the restrictions we're creating for compliance admins or records manager within the Compliance Center on managing these regulatory record labels. So first of all, let's jump into the machine and start with a prerequisite. We are creating an opt-in feature, which requires you to actually run a PowerShell commandlet to enable the regulatory record label. This is an extra precaution to make sure that only organizations which have understood the strictness of the regulatory record label want to enable it and use it are the ones that do this. So after I've connected to the Security and Compliance Center through PowerShell, I will actually run the set regulatory compliance UI commandlet and set that to true. And when I do a quick get, I'll actually see that it has been appropriately enabled. After this, I'll be able to go to Compliance Center and see how to set a regulatory record. So let me flip over to the Compliance Center. In here, I could use the solution catalog or just go to my records management solution on the left-hand side, as I would typically do. And under File Plan, where you're used to managing all your retention labels and record labels, you will be able to create the new regulatory record label. So let's take a look at how to do that. I'm going to go ahead and create a label, give it a quick friendly name as financial regulatory records. I'm going to skip adding any file plan descriptors for it. Then I arrive at the center of the record label, which is its retention settings that it enforces. First thing we have to do is make sure that we specify the appropriate period we want to retain this for. I'm going to leave it as the default of 7 years based on when the item was created for the start of the period. Then I get to choose how strict is this label going to be during those 7 years. I could choose our typical retention, which doesn't actually prevent any editing. Just make sure that the file stays around if it tries to be deleted. I could choose to mark the item as a record, which will prevent editing on the file, but it still allows records versioning or editing of metadata. And our new option of marking the item as a regulatory record. When I select that, I'll actually get a warning, even for me as an admin, to make sure that I understand the restrictions of a regulatory record label and how, when this is applied, it won't be able to be removed. After I confirm this is what I want to do, I'll click yes, I'm sure, and I'll be able to continue. Now, in this case, at the end of the retention period, I could choose to delete the items automatically, or what I actually want to do is have someone review it. In this case, I want to have a human go through it and approve the disposition of each one of my records. So I select that, and the next step will be to choose who should be reviewing that disposition. I'll quickly select Tina and one of our admins to be able to do that review when the item expires. After I've done that, I can review my settings, make sure it all looks good, and then create the label. Once the label is created, we normally give you two options for how to make this label available to content or to your end users. The first one is publishing the label for manual application or even setting it as a default on a folder or document library or a folder in the inbox. And the other one is auto-applying, in which we use rules to be able to match to content and automatically apply that label. For regulatory record labels, and initially in this first release, we will not be allowing the auto application to help customers with accidental or unintentional cases where you might automatically declare a lot of records that you can't undeclare and you can't remove. And so we're only making available the ability to publish it for manual labeling or as a default on a folder. So I will choose to publish this label manually and then go ahead and confirm that's the right label. And just like any other label, I can select the locations. We support all the same locations that retention labels support today with the regulatory record label, including Exchange, OneDrive, SharePoint, and any of those locations that you're used to. I could choose to scope this to just one site in SharePoint maybe, or just one mailbox in Exchange, but I'm going to select that it goes everywhere for this demo. I'll then just provide a very quick name for my policy and finish this off. It may take about a day at maximum for this to be available within your tenant for labeling. But while we do that and while we wait a couple of minutes for it to be available, let's actually take a look. The label has been created and I can see that it's marking it as a regulatory record. But also, when I go to edit it, I can actually see that some of the restrictions that I would expect from any label still apply in this case, like I can't edit the name. However, for regulatory records, we actually have additional restrictions. For example, if I try to change the retention period to 1 day after the 7 years was the original time frame, and let's say this might be a case of a malicious insider, maybe an admin that is making a change to try to dispose of records that shouldn't be doing. When I try to do that, I will actually get an error from the system warning me that you are not able to shorten the preservation time for regulatory record labels. You can only make it that it will be there for longer, but not shorter times. And so this is one of those things that we built right into the system to make it very easy for you to prove that you actually are meeting those regulations. Now let's talk about classifying content. We talked about how we're not allowing yet the auto application of content, but let's talk about how to manually label the content and what are the restrictions imposed in the content as you're there right in the product. Let me flip over to SharePoint. And in SharePoint, I can see a typical document library. And just like I would be used to normally, a regulatory record label can be applied by the same user interface that built right into SharePoint to be able to apply any other retention label. I'll see the regulatory record label in combination with all the other labels of the tenant. And as I select it as an end user, I'll also get a warning of if this is an operation I want to confirm. As we've talked, it is really important to know that once you apply this, you are not able to remove the label. So it is important for end users to make that conscious choice and confirm through the dialog. I'll go ahead and click apply, and then I am able to declare this as a record. I see the label has been applied, and this is now a regulatory record. What that means is if I try to edit that title and maybe go to the editing of properties and try to change the title, which is just metadata on the file, when I try to save, it'll actually prevent me from saving those changes. And even if I go into the file and try to move it, we are allowing the file to move within the current library to different folders. As you see here, that was a successful operation, and it can go into financial statements and find it there. And so we are allowing it to move within the document library as that it, you can reorganize your regulatory records. However, if I try to move it to a different location, say a different site collection, I'll actually get an error, and it'll tell me that the label that's applied will prevent this action. This is because we want to make sure all of your metadata that you have applied on this regulatory record, which could be custom metadata columns on the SharePoint document library, are actually being protected and being stored for you for the years that you define. Once I've done this, let's talk about this in the terms of execution and what to do when the disposition of an item that is a regulatory record label comes up. So just like any other record or item that you've set for disposition review, when the period of the financial regulatory records items comes up, you will be able to get an email that warns you that there are some items pending review. You can click on the link from the email and end up in the disposition review experience where I can easily select the label that I'm here to help with disposition of, so financial regulatory records. And in there, I can see all the items pending disposition. One of the new features that we just shipped is that you, with the right permissions, can see the contents of that file that you're trying to approve the disposal of right from within the compliance center and the disposition review experience. This makes it much easier so you can validate this is the right file you think it is without having to ever leave this experience. I can even see the information or even the details that we have, any metadata around the item before I approve or perform any other action. If I approve the deletion of this content, I'm able to provide a comment just like always. And then once I do that, I'll see this file disappear from my list of pending dispositions and move into the disposed items as it gets deleted. And in that deletion, it'll still contain all of that metadata around the comment for the approval. And just like other records, we'll be storing the proof of disposal for this regulatory record for up to 7 years. Now, we're very excited to announce that thanks to the introduction of the regulatory record label, along with other features that increase the robustness for immutability within Microsoft 365, we've had a third party assess how you can use Microsoft 365 to appropriately configure it to help meet the SEC 17A4 rule, FINRA compliance, and CFTC. And we're happy to announce that there's a new report coming from Cohasset, which we will be posting in our technical documentation, where you can read how SharePoint, OneDrive, Teams, and Skype for Business, in addition to the already existing report around Exchange Online, can help you meet those really strict regulations. Before we go, I just wanted to leave you with some resources that I encourage you all to go check out. We've had a lot of announcements at Ignite, so please check out both the recording of the session where we do all the announcements, as well as our blog where we talk all about what's new. And of course, always check out our documentation. It has the latest information on all of our features and how you can leverage the most out of them. If you want to try any of these features, please start an E5 compliance trial now and take this for a test run right on your same tenant. And finally, we are listening and we want your feedback. Please contact us on User Voice and let us know anything that you'd like to see in the product and help with voting with the different features that others have suggested. Thank you very much, and I hope you're as excited to get started with regulatory records as we are to share this with you.